money and check out the description below for the weekly deals on QuickBooks Online. If you need help deciding on what QuickBooks Online is right for your business, check the description below to find a link for a free consultation. QuickBooks Online Advanced makes it easier for you to import invoices from other business applications. This feature is particularly helpful for users who use external invoice databases or point-of-sale applications. In this video, I will demonstrate how to import invoices from a CSV spreadsheet. Keep in mind that you can't add discounts, credit memos, and negative amounts to your import. The first step is to prep your spreadsheet. Let's use our sample CSV file to go through each column available to import your invoices. In our sample template, columns marked with an asterisk is required. First is the invoice number. If you have custom transaction numbers, enter the number. Otherwise, QuickBooks will choose a number for you. Here's a quick tip. If an invoice contains multiple products and/or services in one invoice, then the spreadsheet you import needs to reflect this. You can see that invoice 1001 contains 4 products and services. If these weren't separated into individual rows, then QuickBooks Online would take the total amount of the invoice and categorize the product under one product or service name. The next column is customer. This is a required field, so you want to enter the customer name. If that customer doesn't exist in QuickBooks, you will have the option to add it to your customer list during the import. The next column shows a service date. This is the date the service was performed. This field is optional. Then you have the invoice date. This is the date of the invoice, and this is a required field. The due date is the date the invoice is due to be paid, and this is another required field. Then you have the terms, and that is the terms of the invoice, and this is not a required field. Next up is the item. The item, which is otherwise known as a product or service, be careful with this field. If you have the product or service set up in QBO, with the category you want to add, you want to add that first with the colon and then the product service following. For example, landscaping is a category and trimming is the service. Also keep in mind, if product or service isn't added, QuickBooks populates with a generic item called sales. QuickBooks does not have this marked as a required field, but it will not import unless it's filled out. The item description field is optional. If you leave this field blank, it will not autofill from your item field from your item list. The next column is the item quantity. This is the number of service hours or quantity of products sold. This field is not required. Next, you have the item rate. You want to enter the rate of your product or service. This field is not required. Then you have the item amount. This is the total amount of the product or service for the line item of the invoice. This field is required. And the next one is taxable. Is the item taxable? You want to enter Y for yes or N for no. Then you have the item tax code. You would enter the item tax code to show on the invoice. This field is required. They should have made the taxable field a required field as well. Next is the memo. Here is where you can enter any notes that you want to add to the invoice. This is not a required field. Then you have the email column. This is where you can enter the email of the contact person who will receive the invoice. This is not a required field. I'm going to circle back to the invoice number. If your invoices have multiple line items, make sure each line entry fills in the required fields. Otherwise, the import will not work. Basically, just like my sample file and not the one that QuickBooks gave you. If your spreadsheet has new products or services and/or vendors, be sure to add them in QuickBooks before importing. Also, QuickBooks Online Advanced allows you to import a maximum of 100 invoices at a time with a 1,000 row limit per spreadsheet import. In our current example, invoice 1001 would be considered 4 invoices counting towards the 100 invoice limit, with 10 product service lines counting towards the 1,000 row limit. The next step is to turn on the custom transaction numbers. So if you use numbers to track your invoices, like what we showed in the invoice number column, turn on custom transaction numbers in QuickBooks. If you don't turn this on, QuickBooks will automatically number the invoices for you. So first you want to go to Settings, underneath the gear icon, and select Account and Settings. Select the Sales tab, then select Edit in the Sales Form Content section. Select Custom Transaction Numbers and turn on the option. And then lastly, you want to select Save. Next, we need to upload your spreadsheet. You want to go to Settings, again, underneath of the gear icon, and select Import Data. Then select Invoices. Next, select Browse, and then find and select the spreadsheet of your invoices. If you have new imported customers without setting its proper currency, QuickBooks assumes the currency is United States dollar. If you have multi-currency turned on, you can import invoices in foreign currencies. If you have new customers that don't already exist in QuickBooks, select the checkbox under the Browse button. Select Next. Now we want to map your import fields. We want to make sure the spreadsheet's column headings match with the QuickBooks fields. So map the column headers with invoice fields in QuickBooks. You would want to make sure that any fields that are marked with an asterisk have entries. Select Non-Applicable for any fields not in your spreadsheet. Select the date format you use. Next, you want to select your item tax code as your tax option. Select Next. Now you want to map your tax rates to match your sales tax performed previously in taxes. Click Next. My screen shows that 4 new invoices will be imported with 3 new customers that were found, which will also be added. Click Complete Import. Once you are done, select Done if all of your invoices are imported. If some invoices fail to import, note why, then select Done. To check if our import was successful, we'll go to Sales, then All Sales, to view our new invoices where we have 4 new invoices with our 3 new customers. I'll select one of our invoices. This invoice has four rows for items that were sold, all of which were imported in just seconds. Let's go over the invoice. Invoice number 1001 shows on top. The new customer shows in the customer field. The customer email shows. You'll notice that they don't have a field to enter the billing address, so it's blank. Hopefully they will add that soon. The terms, invoice date, due date, also show in the header. The details section of the invoice showed the service date, product, service, description, quantity, rate, amount, and if this item is taxable. To the bottom left, it shows my memo listed on the message on the statement. Lastly, it shows California as a tax collected for all taxable items.
Thanks for watching my video on QuickBooks Online Advanced. For me to keep making more videos to show you how to get the most from QuickBooks, please subscribe and click on the bell to be notified when these new videos are made. Thanks again.